Welcome back to Acting Analysis for Animators, and today is part 3 of Take Shelter. As you may or may not know, I love this movie, and this is a great scene between the brothers, so Michael Shannon, and the other actor's name I can't recall, but he's in Deadwood as well. Great voice, he's so good. So this is kind of the brother came in to see what's going on, to kind of help out, and it's kind of a cry for help on Michael Shannon's part, and I want to talk about how he does that. They're just so different in terms of behavior. One is so soft and kind of shy, introverted, and the other person's a bit more manly and just kind of and it's an interesting contrast between the two characters. But instead of rambling, let's get straight into the shot. Oh, and by the way, as always, I'm gonna upload this one separately because it has a lot of dialogue, but still enough sound that's gonna get me a copyright thing. So as always, this clip, just the clip of the audio, will be an upload that's unlisted, and the link to that one is in the description. Let's go. So they just had their discussion, and you have Michael Shannon here that says, "Hey Kyle," this is Kyle, so he calls him, and what I want you to look at is, throughout the movie, he has a hard time connecting with people and holding eye contact. So he's already, you know, hunched over. I know he's really tall, but he's also really tall there too. So he has this constant avoiding eye line and says, "Hey Kyle," see, even here, he looks at him just to make sure, "Hey, I'm talking to you," but then has to go back down. He's slightly surprised, like, "What's going on? What are you calling me for?" And, you know, but still takes steps towards him. Goes, "Yeah, what's going on?" Just says, "Yeah." And then you see this here, and I love this. He still can't look at him. He has that slight tilt. It's kind of that puppy tilt when you're interested in something. And you can just see this hand coming up, and he actually looks at it. And this is kind of his way of asking for a hug, for love, for connection, for just understanding. But that's all he can do. He brings out this other arm. But it's not like he can go up and tell him, "Hey man, I need your help. I need your emotional support." And throughout the movie, that's kind of his way of doing those things. And you can see in his face, he has to look at this, and it looks at him like, "What's going on?" And then he gets it, because now he's really reaching out. It's like, "All right, okay, I get it. And in if you listen to the clip, he laughs. He, not Shannon, but he laughs. So to him, it's kind of like, really? Okay, I guess we want a hug. And it's not the warm embrace and, you know, you need that help. It's the slapping. Bah, 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 bah. And again, back here, to me, it's just kind of, he is sensitive, he needs emotional support, and he's not that type of guy to do that. It's not that type of relationship. So as he realizes that, I'm not gonna get much of him, and he still knows about all the storms and all that stuff that's coming, he tells him, "Take care of yourself." And his response to that is, again, he laughs, kind of snickers, like, okay, has that little look there, he's like, "All right." And he tells him, "I will, little brother." And it's this thing of, and I don't know if this is between brothers. I have an older brother, but he never said that. But it's always kind of like the older brother has to tell the younger brother, "Okay, little brother." It's almost like he's putting him into place. Like, yeah, you don't have to tell me to be careful and to take care of things. You're the one that's messed up, and you take care of yourself. But anyway, I'm reading into that. But he tells him, "Take care of yourself." And he laughs, "Okay, I will, little brother." And then he gives him the advice of, "Take care of your family. Handle your business," right? So that's kind of his thing. Instead of asking, "Okay, what's wrong? What could you do?" And he still has, you know, that pose of, yeah, he's still interested, but this is the, I can't hold eye contact. He still looks down. He has that, you know, hunched over feel. And it's just a totally different relationship. As he realizes that, yeah, I'm not getting much out of him. That's all he can do. He goes for a handshake. And again, he doesn't look at him. And look at the difference of handshakes. I'm just gonna play this out. Bam and bam. So you have this, okay, well, that's all I'm getting from you. And it's not like, okay, you know, it's going to be okay, whatever it is. It's this strong handshake, pulling towards himself. It's just the stronger, you know, I have to say manlier type of thing, but it's just a completely different way of interacting. And even then, he has to give him a little pat on his back. And if you listen to the audio right there, he doesn't exhale. And that's how it ends the shot. And to me, the contrast is that you got this guy, this tall guy, who's just kind of, "Hey man, please, I need your help. And, you know, I need a hug, but that's all I can do in terms of connecting." And instead of the older brother going, "Oh man, what's wrong with you?" And, like, you know, like holding him and asking, it's more like,
yeah, pa-pa-pa, yeah, take care of yourself.
And I love that little exhale. It's as if this was a lot of work. This was exhausting, because he probably has never done that. I'm totally, again, reading into this and I'm guessing. But to me, that backstory, into the way I take this, and the way I would potentially use this in a shot if I had two characters and they're contrasting, I see this as, I'm not that type to discuss things, to get emotional, to ask about feelings. It's more like, yeah, handle your business, take care of your family, I got my truck, and I'm totally stereotypically, I know. But in a painting, broad strokes, that's how I see this. And for him to actually say, take care of yourself and give him a handshake, that was a lot. That was a lot in terms of, I just opened up to my brother and it was exhausting. And that's why he goes, whew, and then exit scenes and the scene is done. But I love this, and I could be totally wrong, but I love this contrast of, again, Michael Shannon always being so introverted and he can't hold eye contact, and the brother going, what is this? Is this a hug? Oh, okay, all right, I'm gonna hug you. Just how he plays that, so good. So if you are doing a shot with two characters and maybe only one character is talking, I would really take a look at how can I differentiate them and make the contrast really, really strong in terms of just body posing. One person, again, I'm not saying you should rip this off, but you know, in this example, one person is always kind of hunched over, not really engaging too much, kind of avoiding eye contact. And even on the hug, it's more like something like this. And the other person kind of very, you know, confident walk, kind of look, what are you doing? All right, I'm guessing getting into this. It's just a very different body language. So if you have two characters or more, I would try to find a way to give all those characters a certain history, a certain, you know, like I said in previous acting analysis and FNAs, you have your pose that's throughout the scene. So when you have your character, you don't have your default T pose and go down, and that's how you start the shot. Think about, is my character always like him, kind of like that, or is it, you know, more confident? So think about head moves, gestures, how confident are they, or how shy or introverted, angry or sad, whatever it is. You should think about each character and their state of mind and how you can give each character contrast so they stand out. And that's it. There's going to be more. There's more to talk about this movie. There's at least two more sequences, but that is it for now. And as always, if you have watched the whole thing till the very end, I highly appreciate it that you take your time. If you like this, give this a like, and if you would like to subscribe and get all the notifications, you know the drill. I would love a subscribe, hit that bell button, and all that good stuff. But for now, that's it. Thank you again for watching, and I will see you for the FNA.